start with this and to try entering this?
Come again, I didn't get you. Little louder, please.
My question is, like advertisements, we are all new, as in we have not done anything as such. Like good. We are making short films and everything, but not advertisements, we haven't started it yet. So how do we begin with it? Like how do you
get into the publication?
Yeah,
fine.
How do we start with it?
Fine. As I told you, advertising, you can switch off this thing, right? See, basically what happens is, creativity in advertising is nothing but thinking differently. For example, if I come and tell you, the early bird catches the worm, it is a statement, you accept it. But you are thinking differently, what will be your question? Try. As I told you, there's nothing wrong in advertising, there's nothing right in advertising. You somewhere, you get onto an idea which overcomes a barrier. What is advertising all about? It's like a river flowing. Have you ever seen a river flowing? The river flows, there's a boulder. Does the river stop flowing? It either goes over it, or goes beside it, or goes there, it floods it, but river keeps moving. So there is always a barrier to a problem. Like a river, advertising is like a river, you overcome the barrier. What stops the other person from listening to me? Or what stops the other person for not choosing me? Or what stops the other person to prevent me from getting into the consideration list? So advertising is only three things. AIDA principle is called as awareness, interest, desire, action. Advertising can create awareness. It can make you go to the store. It can instill interest in you. Out of the 15 chutidars available, this chutidar is the best chutidar. It's got design, interest. Then I want to buy it. It's a desire. We can push all those three. Action is yours. You can still go to the shop and say, no, I'm not buying, go to some other shop. And come back with a lipstick. No problem. Advertising can't do any shit about it. Can't do anything about it. Okay? So coming to your question, advertising is thinking differently. When I ask you a question, the early bird catches the worm. Think of it differently. The worm, even the worm was also early, no? That's why it got caught. So the bird was early, the worm was a little earlier, so it got caught. Different way of thinking is, the worm was coming home from a late night party, so it got caught. It's here, this doesn't work, is it? I don't think it's required. Am I audible? So thinking differently is advertising. That's what we teach in advertising. For example, in client, as a client servicing guy, my job is to enthuse my creative time, my creative people, to think differently of a given product. It is nothing. For example, I talked to you about this Bajaj Caliber motorcycle, right? Why did you think different? You can always say, you can show a macho man like Salman Khan looking at a lot of no shirt, full muscles, driving like that, and say Bajaj Caliber. Why did they think differently? Because the barrier was, even though a man is tough, he has got a heart. He may be a tough looking man, he may be an army guy, he may be a big boulder guy, but still, he has got a heart. When he sees the girl whom he was in love with, but she's already married, she has got a son. He has given that toy to the dog to the little kid and he walks back unaffected. So I have a brand personality. The brand personality means I will never be shaken by anything that happens to me in my life. Like my Bajaj Caliber, the motor bike will never let you down. Right? It keeps moving. That's what advertising is all about. It doesn't require great shakes. Advertising is nothing but structuring of common sense. Why? If you notice very deeply today, common sense is the most uncommon thing amongst common people. The world is in a problem because of that. Nobody uses common sense. Advertising is to structure the common sense. Like talking about, if I have to move from A to B, there are several steps. I'll pass that, I'll go there, that's common sense. No, I want to be different, I'll go somewhere like that. It's up to you, boss, nobody's stopping you. So structuring common sense is advertising. And doing it interestingly is advertising. That's all. Yes.
Sir, so does the advertising industry only focus on constructing the story based on stereotypes? Or do you also make advertisements to break the stereotypes?
Brilliant question, brilliant question. Have you do you remember Onida advertising?
Yes, sir. Onida.
What was that? See, basic advertising, when we joined, they told us, show your product is the hero. Your product will be well polished, neatly presented. People should see the product as an aspirational one. Basic. What did Onida do? Owner's pride. They took a negative aspect of thinking in advertising and said, my product is so good that people will hate you for having it. Get the point. It's a good point. So advertising has to break these barriers. As I told you, the barrier was, the other product is good, they will not buy mine. They think other product. So how I break that barrier? So I break my product and say, people break my product because I am better than that guy. Neighbors envy, owners pride is my storyline. That's how I would have clicked in. Then you add a value in masala, saying that the green-eyed monster of envy, you have a baldy guy and all this stuff. Just to, what do you call, a creative manifestation of the envy. Give a character to envy, give him a body, give him a figure, give him a shape, and give him, put him in green color, and then he becomes your spokesperson. So it is not the hero who is speaking about a product, it is the devil who says this product is much better here, so break it. Get the idea? That's how it is. Good question. It happens, boss. See, as I told you, I have to add value to a product. Either I add value by a story or product superiority. Now everything being banking. Under the Indian banking laws, no bank can give you more than 6% interest or 7% interest for savings bank. Nobody can give you more than 6.75% for your recurring deposit. It's all fixed by Reserve Bank of India. You can't give less, right? So how do I make people come and put their trust and their money in my bank? So it's a level playing field. How do I differentiate myself? So I differentiate myself by either, if I am State Bank of India, I'll say, I am the Indian government bank. I've been in the market for more than 240 years. I'm the oldest bank in the country. And since I'm the oldest bank in the country, I've got more than 12 lakh customers with me. I'm the largest guy, I've got the largest reach, hence bank with me, I'm there wherever you want to. Okay, it's a very interesting story. First thing, safety. My money is safe because it's a government-owned bank. For information, only the State Bank of India is a government-owned bank. None of other banks are government-owned banks. Government has a partnership in banks. The nationalized banks are not owned by the government of India. Only State Bank of India is owned by the government of India. So he has got one unfair advantage. Right? So how do I make myself different? So I say, look, I'll bring Amitabh Bachchan. He will come and tell me, please trust me. Because he's a trusted figure, successful figure. He has got a good family. See, there's a brand fit. If I bring Amitabh Bachchan to sell a scooter, it'll never sell. Get a point. Because people view him as the grand old daddy of the movie industry. He is trusted, he has been successful, his family is good. There are no scandals about him. You get the point. See, when I am doing a celebrity management, when I am looking at a celebrity brand fit, these are the things I look into. The fees are different. See, the fees are amortized. By paying Amitabh Bachchan 1 crore for 2 years of advertising, it is nothing. You have amortized the number of target audience you have, number of business growth you're going to have, it's nothing. See, what is advertising all about? Advertising is making sure that your message reaches the maximum amount of people at the lowest unit cost. That's where media you'll have to think about. What is your lowest unit cost? For example, if I take, you saw my media plan, like OTS. I use newspapers, I use televisions, I use blah, 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 blah. I get to TRP of the televisions, GRP, maximum reach. So my ad, by using this media mix, for 1 year, will cost you 2 crores. But in this 1 year, the OTS is 5 times. And target audience is about, India is a country full of population. There are 50 crore people will see your ad for 5 times in a given year. So, at 2 crores, I am reaching a message for 250 crore times. So, divide 2 crore by 250 is lesser than the cost of a matchbox or one chocolate. Give one chocolate and say, cost of reach is only one chocolate, sir. Please approve the ad. That's where it comes in. Who has this question about celebrity? So, these are all amortized costs. Cost of Amitabh Bachchan is 1 crore. Media shooting costs is 40 lakhs. Media reaches 1.5 crores. Taxes and so on, so is about 35 lakhs. All put together about 2.5 crores. But I'm reaching about 250 crore people. So what is the cost? Amortized, simple. See, it happens in any, in the market. Any product you buy, what is a cool drink you like very much? Tell me. I love you, man. Your name, please. Hey, interesting guy. Good. What's your name? Butapa? I like you. Okay, anyway. What is the cost? 7-Up, how much do you pay? 15 rupees. You know what is the cost of 7-Up one bottle?
5 or 6.
Give me. 3 to 4 rupees.
Uh-huh.
200 ml one bottle, green bottle. Of your famous 7-Up, is cost of manufacturing about 80 paise. X factory price of 7-Up, without taxes, without anything, is 80 paise, one bottle. Boss, I worked on FMCG brands, I can tell you. You pay 15 rupees because all the costs are added up. Your taxes are added up, celebrity costs are added up, television costs are added up, my reach costs are added up, your trucking costs are added up. In any FMCG product, okay, I'll be very frank about any FMCG product. The difference between the cost of manufacture, X factory price, and MRP is about 60 to 70%. It's a fact of life. There's a distribution cost, there's a transportation cost, there's a taxes, there are distributor margin, retailer margin, wholesaler margin. See, nobody is giving you service for free. Huh? Please understand, anything is given free to you. You are the product. Because your data will be sold.
Facebook.
Exactly. If anything is free, you are the product. Nothing is free in life. Right? So, coming to it, you amortize the cost, nothing will happen. That's why I said in my advertising, there's A to S ratio. Advertising to sales ratio. In FMCG, about 7% is A to S ratio is acceptable, but it's a thumb rule. 7 to 8% is okay. If I'm launching a product, it may go up to 15%. If it's a new category launch, it may go up to 25%. Always when an aircraft takes off, it uses more fuel to climb. Reaches 30,000 feet, cruising level, it does not use fuel. So to reach that height, you have to spend money. That's what we tell advertisers. You have a goal, you have to take off, spend that goddamn money, open your papers. Look, boss, if you're a new girl in town, you have to lift your skirt a little, simple. Or else you can't sell. That's advertising. That's what we tell you all. Okay. Next question.